Here, what you should observe is at the entry, it enters this particular wheel. If I show slightly isometric view, it will be something like this. So entry is being made through this width of the blades. So this height is nothing but width of the blade through which the entry is being made. And then even the exit is through some width. This width is kept same in this drawing, but widths may not be same. Means these B's, the width of the blade at the entry is B1, at the exit it will be B2. So what we are talking about, these vanes, means the vanes which are attached to the rotor, so that at the entry and then at the exit is B1 and B2. So the area through which the water enters will be nothing but cylindrical surface area, because this is cylindrical surface area through which the water enters. And if I want the surface area, cylindrical surface area, I have to just open this up. So circumferential length becomes pi d, the width becomes b. Because of that, the cross-sectional area through which the water enters, if you look at this surface, cylindrical surface, becomes pi d into b. So that's why the discharge becomes pi d b, at the entry pi d 1 b 1, and the velocity of flow. Now, this is the velocity of flow. So this particular thing is at the entry, outer level. This particular thing is at the exit or at the inside. So this is velocity triangle at the outlet, this is velocity triangle at the inlet. So area multiplied by this velocity will be giving you the discharge. So that is what is Q equal to pi d1 b1 into vf1. But the same discharge has to go out. So pi d2 b2, if inside diameter is d2, then pi d2 b2 would be the surface area, cylindrical surface area, multiplied by vf2. To explain this, got one more slide. So here there is simple model of the same thing in different angles. So water enters through this gap. So this width, you can see here, this width is nothing but B1, and this big diameter through which water enters is D1. So area, external surface area through which the water enters, is pi D1 B1 into VF1. Similarly, water comes out from these vanes, this space. Again, this is a cylindrical surface area having width B2. And then let's say the diameter is D2, then the area through which the water is coming out is pi d2 b2, and velocity of flow is vf2. So if you go back and then try to see, I think you'll be able to appreciate this formula. The discharge is equal to pi d1 b1. D1 is the diameter at the inlet, which is outer diameter. D2 is the diameter at the inlet, which is the exit diameter. So here it is shown as R1 external, R2 as the internal. So now, overall, what we have seen is this diagram, how to draw a reaction turbine, the schematic sketch of Francis turbine. So here there is a scroll casing with lesser diameter, bigger diameter. Then water has to enter through wicket gates. It has to flow onto the runner. Runner is attached to the shaft. When water comes out, it runs through draft tube. The draft tube, partially, it will be immersed in tail race. So that is what is feature over here. The wicket gates are adjustable gates. Inside that, you have got runner. So this particular proof we have seen. Ultimately, hydraulic efficiency of the turbine in reaction turbine is given by VW1 divided by GH, because W2 generally it will be 0. If it is given, then it will be VW1 U1 plus or minus VW to U2 divided by GH. And we know how to draw these inlet and outlet velocity triangles. Okay, thank you.